you know y is equal to mx plus c. M is positive, so it is having positive slope. C is positive, so it is having positive intercept. That means M is positive. M is equal to, I told you, it is tan theta. M is positive means tan theta must also be positive. Tan theta positive means theta must be less than 90 degrees. M is negative, this is positive. M is negative means tan theta also negative, but tan theta is negative in second quadrant, that is so if M is positive and C is positive, we can write M is positive means, just now I told you, this line should make an angle less than 90 degrees with a positive x-axis. Suppose if I take the straight line like this, with a positive x-axis, it makes an angle greater than 90 degrees. So its slope will be negative. This slope will be positive. And the intercept is also positive. That means somewhere it has to touch. It has to intersect with the y-axis. That is, the line will be like this. This is C, and this tan theta will be slope. Slope is equal to M, that is equal to tan theta. For example, Y is equal to MX minus C. MX minus C. Here it has positive slope, but intercept is negative. That means the straight line must make an angle less than 90 degrees with a positive x-axis, one condition, because slope is positive. But intercept is negative. Y-intercept is negative. So, it has to intersect the y-axis negative y-axis. So, it will be minus c. Next, slope is positive. That is theta. Next, in the same way, suppose if you take minus mx plus c, minus mx, y is equal to minus mx plus c. So slope is negative, but intercept is positive. Intercept is positive, that's why you can take, here is c, so it passes through that point and intersect this y-axis at c. This value is equal to c, but slope is negative. Slope is negative. That means you can't take the straight line like this. If you take like this, so this is x-axis, this will be theta, this is less than 90 degrees. So tan value, if theta is less than 90 degrees, is positive. So slope would be positive, but here slope is negative. That means theta must be greater than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees. So the straight line must be in this way. This is greater than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees. But it should intersect y-axis at this point. So what I am doing, I am drawing this straight line like this. Here, this angle is theta. So slope M is equal to tan theta, but the intercept is positive. Next, y is equal to minus mx minus c. Intercept is negative, slope is also negative. How the equation will be, graph will be? Slope is negative, so it should make an angle greater than 90 degrees with a positive x-axis. And intercept is again negative, that's why on y-axis, negative y-axis, it should intersect the straight line should intersect the y-axis. So I should not draw like this, because if I draw, it makes an angle theta less than 90 degrees with the positive x-axis, but it should make angle greater than 90 degrees because slope is negative. So the line must be in this way. If we know the equation, then we can draw the graph, straight line graph. And previously what we have studied, if we know the graph, we can develop the equation. So this is about straight lines.